This historic march is part of a day-long gathering that dates back to 1823 and the founding of the Lanark Highland and Friendly Society, dedicated to the celebration and preservation of Highland dress, the Gaelic tongue, and to support loyal, peaceful, and manly conduct. Led by current patron Sir James Forbes, the elect clansmen of Lanark, decked in the family tartans of Forbes, Wallace, or Gordon, parade past the communities of Strathdon and Rough Park, falling out at select points en route for a medicinal glass of whiskey.
Highlanders! Halt! Assume a lazy posture!
Is that how you've managed all that?
Well, no, you've got to do it very carefully.
With drams drained and thirsts quenched, it's back out on the road for the next leg of the journey.
This was originally a march to arms, wasn't it?
Oh, yes!
This cart, in fact, was to pick up the injured?
Oh, definitely not. This was the cart and the gear.
Right.
The camping gear. See, okay. When you camp, shoot a couple of deer, barbecue them, get your food.
It's still an impressive and slightly ferocious sight, seeing everyone marching down here with their pikes.
Ah, but they're friendly people.
They are friendly people.
Yes.
The march culminates in a hearty lunch, which kicks off with steaming bowls of classic Scotch broth at the recently refurbished Lanark Hall.
It's an extraordinary event. This is the 169th in a row. I mean, they've never missed a year in 169 years. There's another wee town just down the road has the prettiest one, and some people have bigger ones, and some of this and some of that. But this is known as the friendliest one.
It's a wonderful atmosphere. I joined the walk this morning and everyone was chatting, and obviously they chatted more each time they stopped for a dram.
I said, the march, they have 8 stops and they get a large one at every, a double whiskey at every stop.
I'm very, very impressed. And then and they have a big lunch and then they come here and they all march
instead. They march, yeah. I'm sure that's why they march, to work off the booze.
Yeah. How important, Billy, are events like this for Scottish culture as a whole?
I think it's massively important because they're totally unique. Like the throwing the hammer and tossing the caber, for instance, are uniquely Scottish, started in Scotland, and that have travelled to... Well, the caber hasn't travelled the world so much, but it's adored all over the world. What, you throw trees? Throwing it's okay. Getting it off the floor is the difficult bit. But what I wish was that they'd bring back the men dancing. See, a lot of these girls, they're doing men's dances, like the Highland Fling and the Sword Dance. Highland Fling's about hunting stags, you know. The Sword Dances was before you go, it was a kind of war dance. Well, it's now done by wee girls with little pumps on, you know.
Perhaps it's been stigmatised by the Morris dancing tradition in England.
But I love
put people
Morris
off.
Dancing.
I love Morris dancing, but we're in the minority, I think.
Aye. The kilt is important to me. Although, this is MacLean, and you got a lot of people saying, oh, how come you're Connolly and you're wearing MacLean? You can wear anything.
Yeah.
You can wear Balmoral. There's an Elvis Presley tartan. There's a Bay City Rollers. Every city has a tartan. Scotland has a tartan. You can wear any one you like. There's such nonsense talked about it. But I just love the shape of it. I like the way men look in it.
Tell me, why come to Scotland?
Come to Scotland for fresh air, fishing, walking, good food, nice people. And don't come for a tan. You know, you're not going to get it. Sometimes you'll get a tan, most of the times you'll rust a little. The weather's unpredictable. My old fishing mate, Jimmy Kent, said there's no such thing as bad weather. There's only the wrong clothes.
Billy, thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us.
It's an absolute pleasure.
And it's wonderful to be here on such a lovely day.
It's a great day, and it'll rain, and it'll get dark, and it'll get light, and it'll be sunny, and it's absolutely normal.
Boo!
So, this, Charlie, is the drawing room. Mm-hmm. So this is the kind of obviously a part of the castle that the people actually see.
And these are all relatives?
All relatives, all ancestors looking at me with, you know,
see
an intense glare.
Yeah, is he getting it right?
Yes, well, how I look at it is I look at it as a custodian. I'm not actually an owner of anything. I'm here to keep it in trust. But you know, I'm one link in a chain that goes back 800 years, and my mission really is not to be the weak link.
And obviously you've made a number of changes. How has the local community responded to all of that?
Well, I think generally people have been very supportive because they've understood the value of this place and how important it is to Skye and the tourist economy. And in here, Charlie, it's a room predominantly of Jacobite relics, but the most famous of which really is the waistcoat of Bonnie Prince Charlie.
Look at that.
He gave it to Flora MacDonald as a token of thanks when she helped him escape the redcoats disguised as a woman. And in this cabinet is the Rory Moore drinking horn. My father drained this in one go, in one gulp. It contains 1.5 litres of claret. He drained this in about 1 minute and 56 seconds without taking breath, setting down, and it was still standing at the end.
It's like the clan equivalent of the yard glass, I guess.
Exactly. I mean, it's. I don't think health and safety people would be too keen on someone trying that. But if you're willing to take the risk,
I'll sign the appropriate documentation.
Then okay.
That is a tremendous honour.
Well, I didn't manage to find.
No, it's a shame we haven't got claret, but
wine, I think, will do.
Yep.
One and a half bottles. So are you sure, Charlie, that you'd like to try this? Because it hasn't been used since 1956.
And it does look a bit musty, but I think that'll give it some authenticity.
You think it'll give it a bony tang?
Yeah, yeah.
All right, well, shall I do the honours and...
Would you call? Lovely, rich bouquet.
We need to get... I'm not sure where it should come to. I think it should just go up to the rim like that.
That'll do.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1...
Done.
Wow, well done, well done. Charlie, that was unbelievable.
Oh, I'm going to be really quite suzzled in a moment.
Do you want to have a lie down?
Well, I think perhaps some food, food? After that, just to
soak it all up. Okay, shall we pump your stomach?
Well, let's just go and get some brown bread.
Yes, okay, let's go.